Patriotas, México is under siege. A plot as insidious as it is dangerous threatens our nation. Outcasts from Rome and from all over Europe are coming into our country to destabilize the government, to poison the minds and hearts of our people, to turn them into fanatics at the service of foreign interests. This situation, this evil, this threat cannot be ignored, and it will not be tolerated. Therefore, I have instructed our Congress to create a set of laws designed to deal with this national emergency. Firstly, every foreign-born bishop, priest, or minister will be deported immediately. Second, there will be a 5-year jail sentence for any priest who criticizes the government. The wearing of religious vestments in public is strictly forbidden. Make no mistake, this government is going to do whatever is necessary to preserve the dignity of Mexico, the freedom of its people, and the immortal ideals of La Revolución Mexicana.
I'm ashamed of you. He's a man of God.
Padre. Padre. Jose will work for you for the next 2 weeks, Padre. Anything you need him to do for the church.
That won't be necessary. It was a harmless prank. And I hear fruit is good for the hair.
I know that priests consider prayer a penitence, but for a boy like my godson, hard work is better.
You've no doubt heard about the Calle's Law.
Yes.
Just be careful about wearing a cassock in public. God save us from these heathens.
Have you had breakfast, Joselito? Elodia makes wonderful chilaquiles. And my friend Father Vega will be here any minute.
Don't call me Joselito.
Oh, that's right. You're tough. I forgot.
The soldiers are coming into towns, making sure the laws are being enforced.
I came from Europe over 70 years ago when I was just 7 years old. Would they really kick out an old man like me?
From what I hear, they probably will. There have been spontaneous protests all over Mexico.
Our resistance is forming, and Rome is taking too long to respond.
An armed resistance?
Let's pray it doesn't come to that, but it may become inevitable.
That's a mistake. Our savior is the Prince of Peace.
But the Bible also says there is a time for peace, a time for war. We cannot allow the godless to take away our freedom. If need be, we must stand up and resist.
Even if I were younger, I would not fight.
You won't need to fight to help. You can feed and shelter the ones who come through here.
Now that I would do.
Listo, listo, soy feliz.
His Holiness Pope Pius XI condemns the Calles Law. Beginning midnight on August 1st, all holy services in Mexico will be suspended.
Is going to beat me in chess today?
Me?
You?
Yes.
Okay, we'll see.
The cathedral is being closed at the orders of President Calles so the government can make an inventory and safeguard its contents.
Let's go.
The girls will not be able to get their confirmation, Enrique.
It's only temporary to leave. Calles won't be able to sustain this. Besides, I'm sure our daughters will survive without the nuns slapping their palms. All that holy nonsense.
It isn't a joke. It may mean nothing to you, but it means everything to me.
Daddy, does that mean no more catechism? So you can play now?
You can study science for now.
You know how important this is to me.
It's only temporary. Besides, I'm sure there'll be plenty of clandestine services.
So the girls can feel like they're doing something shameful when they go to mass.
What do you want me to do?
Come.
Tula.
Look at that.
As a military man, I can tell you that it's only a matter of time before Calles is overthrown. In the meantime, you can teach the girls at home. Unless, of course, you want me to.
Excuse me, sir. Please, for the repeal of the Calles Law.
Please don't misunderstand me. I'm a good Catholic, but you're wasting your time.
Excuse me?
What good do you think this will do?
Cadiz can't ignore Emily's signatures.
I'm sorry to say he can, and he will. But on the other hand, an economic boycott, that would be quite a different matter.
Brilliant, Adriana. This is a brilliant idea.
Thank you, but it wasn't mine.
It is very, very ambitious. But why not? A big sacrifice.
Only buy what we absolutely need.
A type of Lent. But these will attest to our faith. And it will humble Calles.
Jose, it seems Dr. Limone has lost his watch. Have you found anything while you've been speaking?
No, Padre.
Huh. He must have lost it somewhere else. You're a good sweeper, Jose. I think you'd be a better altar boy. Well done.
Did I tell you? You cannot be soft with these people. They confuse reason with weakness. I showed restraint. What did they do? Become more rebellious, more insolent. The purpose of this boycott is very evident. They want to wreck the economy and bring our government down.
Congress rejected the petition.
There'll be no stopping the uprisings now.
The boycott is working.
They're afraid, and it's showing.
It's not easy. We have thousands of supporters all over the country. We can do this.
So, I tried. Followed your advice. Did not work. So now, the next message I send will be unmistakably clear.
Come on! were so lucky. They thought you were dead.
But this is a monster.
I know.
We must find another peaceful solution.
Anacleto, the armed conflict has already begun. I say we support the rebellion.
They'll need food, medicine,
and ammunition. We can support them with communication and funds. But we will not fight.
I kneel first time.
Bring.
Then will I bring the host up here? Ring the bell. Then I go down here. Right?
Finally.
He's teaching me to be an altarman.
You? I thought you were being punished.
Enrique, we have a problem with the machine 4.
Bravo, sir.
Hi.
Beautiful. Look at this. Charles Lindbergh crosses the Atlantic. Solo. Me, I'm here, going mad, surrounded by pink soap.
You have a beautiful family and enough memories of battle to last a lifetime.
Memories. You live in your memories, you're already dead.
I saw you at the church. Are you a gardener now?
Maybe an altar boy.
Really?
Elena!
I'll see you later.
Safe here, Joselito. Jose. Who are you if you don't stand up for what you believe? There is no greater glory than to give your life for Christ. Now. Go.
Please, Father.
Go and run fast.
Let this be a lesson to any of you who help traitors cristeros.
José, mi amor. ¿Estás bien? Thank the Lord. Mi amor. They killed Padre Christopher. I told him he could come here. But he wouldn't come with me. I should have made him come with me.
José. It was very brave of you to try.
Godfather punished him.
Your padrino is a mayor. But even he has no power over the federales.
Anacleto González Flores.
Yes.
This is the most I could get.
Umberto, God bless you.
We need to take 5 bills each if we can. Let me show you.
Thank you.
Spend it in hell, come on.
We have over 20,000 men who call themselves defenders or populists. Most don't even know of each other's existence. That's why we need a commander-in-chief and a central command. What about your military friends?
Well, they suggested Enrique Gorostieta. An experienced, decorated general in strategist. He defeated Zapata.
I know of him. I doubt he's sympathetic to our cause. I don't even think he's Catholic.
We are not hiring him to pray. He's a great man, capable of doing great things.
Close your eyes and sleep with the angels.
I'll try.
Okay. My mother brought us that vase from Sevilla.
Sorry, mother.
You looking for me?
Come out, cabrón! Got you surrounded.
heard they rode by chuchos. We came as fast as we could. You're right. Who else came to help?
Go get the rest of the guns and the ammunition and their horses.
For Cristeros now, boys!
How many?
Six.
Six. Four here. Four there. 14.
14. 14.
Miguel Gomez Loza.
Enrique Gorostieta. Sit down, please.
I represent the National League for the Defense of Religious Liberty.
Maybe you have heard us referred to as the League.
I've heard you called by another name. Cristeros.
Surely you don't support Calles?
No. He's a barbarian and a fool.
There are uprisings all around the country. Over 20,000 men, but no leader.
No leader. I am not what you might call a devout believer.
We propose to hire you to turn our armed resistance into a formidable army.
An army. I thank you, sir, for a most generous offer. Okay. Let's make an army. Let's make a formidable army out of a group of ragtag peasants and huaraches. Out of a few game ranchers. Out of some tender-footed clergy who are trembling at the thought of holding a weapon for the first time. You want me to make a National Guard out of that? Look at me. Do you have proper weapons? No. Do you have an ammunition supply? No. Do you have a central command? No. How many is that? Three no's. All you have is belief. But belief will not save them in battle.
Central Command. The League has an extensive secret network all over Mexico. Weapons, ammunition from the centers within the army itself, and soldiers we have defeated.
Surely you have read about our victories in your paper.
And your defeats.
General. That's why we want to hire you.
I suppose I'm interested in your offer. What are your finances? You gonna pay me in prayers?
Tell me what you want, and I'll bring it back to the League.
I don't think the Cristeros can afford me.
The question here is, where does the finest general in Mexico want to serve?
If I don't take these photographs, who will? Who will record this barbarity that wouldn't be believed?
Why didn't they shoot you?
I always promised them a portrait. Ten seconds. Miguel? Hijo, what happened? Are you all right?
Yes, Father. There was a big battle. Bullet went right through my ankle. They killed my horse.
I regret, Dr. Limon.
No, it's better if no one knows.
No one will know. I have known him for almost 30 years.
Will you be all right?
Boys, time to go. Don't tell anyone what you saw here.
Legendary El 14.
Victoriano Ramirez.
My brother, Pablo. They should be here, Pablo. Bring them inside.
Where is the general?
I'm sorry, I didn't introduce myself. General Jose Reyes Vega.
You're General Vega?
Yes.
You're a priest?
I'm a priest.
Priest general, huh? Oh, all right.
Some water?
What else do you have?
Some tequila, help yourself.
You know, I heard that your last battle didn't go so well. Now I know why.
Really?
Maybe priests shouldn't be generals, hmm?
Of course, we didn't know you would be fighting so close. Did you know that you drove the Federales right into our camp when we were completely unprepared?
You were completely unprepared? And this is my fault?
I'm saying we should be working together.
Under whose command?
The League appointed me, Commander.
Well, I don't know anything about any League, Padre. I'm fighting for Cristo Rey, La Virgen de Guadalupe. And I'm responsible for my own men.
Together we will be much stronger.
We'll stay out of your way. We're going to Atlanta.
Jose, women are here with ammunition.
Bring Adriana in.
The what?
The women with the ammunition.
Que viva Cristo Rey, padre.
Que viva.
I also brought three nurses.
God bless you, Adriana. God bless you and thank you, ladies. You are as important to this war as any soldier. God bless you.
Padre. Excuse me, Padre. You think that's right, to involve women like this?
Our Catholic sisters are a big part of this war. Without them bringing ammunition, food, taking care of the wounded, all would be lost.
All right.
Do you need ammo? Guns?
No. You keep the ladies' ammunition, Padre. We've got plenty from the Federales we've killed.
What is the occasion?
An attorney for the League representing the Cristeros came to see me today. They want to hire me to command the rebellion.
You?
Yes.
Well, how ironic. You cannot fight for something you don't believe in.
I may have issues with the church, but I believe in religious freedom. And I believe in you. And if I'm successful, the church bells will ring freely again. And our girls, they can continue their catechism.
You are really considering this?
Yes. Lolita, I have asked him for 3,000 pesos a month. That's twice what the federal generals make. Plus 50,000 in insurance for you and the girls. They've agreed to everything.
50,000? If you die.
I'm not gonna die.
So you have it all figured out. And where do I and the girls fit in this?
Lolita, listen to me. I'm dying here. I'm a military man. You knew that when you married me.
You are Cristero. You are an atheist.
Are you awake? Turn him down.
You may have nothing you believe in, but I do. I believe in what you would be fighting for. Maybe by doing it, you will too. Just come back to me, Herrera. To us, to the loving man I made.
The American Secretary of State. ¿Cómo se llama el gringo ese?
Mr. Kellogg.
Kellogg. He's making the outrageous remark that Bolshevik forces are at work in Mexico and stating that we have to guarantee the life and property of every U.S. citizen in Mexico. What does he think I am? Mexico will not tolerate foreign governments meddling in our internal affairs.
Thank you for coming.
Not at all.
Dwight, do you speak any Spanish?
Just a little.
Look, I'll be blunt. Our ambassador to Mexico has botched things. Badly. You've revamped aviation policy. You've been General Pershing's right-hand man. I think you can handle ambassador to Mexico.
Cal, my dear friend, I'm honored.
Don't answer now. Think about it. Talk it over with Elizabeth.
What's the real story?
President Calles is repealing the Bucareli agreements. 50 years and our oil concessions are finished.
And what would you like me to do, Mr. President?
What you always do. Fix it.
Let's be frank. You called them Bolsheviks.
I was simply calling a spade a spade. Would you have us just roll over and let them steal our oil fields?
How do you think offending them is going to help our cause? President Coolidge wants a diplomatic approach. I'm convinced he's right. Half of Europe just became the Soviet Union. We need Mexico in more ways than one.
Well, I warn you from experience that there's no negotiating with Calles.
Thank you for your assessment and your advice, but I am the current ambassador to Mexico. The results of your tenure speak for themselves. Now, why am I getting all this pressure from the Knights of Columbus? about this conflict between Caius and the church.
Conflict? No, that's nothing.
Francisco!
Take the dynamite bullets, sir.
Clear the people from this area!
Andale, forme fila! Muevase, muevase!
Clear this area, we're blowing the safe!
Camine, camine! Vámonos!
It's lit, sir.
Passengers out.
Yes, sir, they are.
Then what are you waiting for? Set fire to this train!
Andale, what is it? Andale, andale.
We got it!
One of it.
So-called cristeros burned hundreds of innocent people alive. The Mexican government has proved that the Roman Catholic Episcopate ordered this atrocity. Bishops have agreed to leave the country, avoiding responsibility, and abandon Mexico.
General, everything's ready. You can communicate to troops in any area through us. Best undercover operative. They'll accompany you. This is for you. Viva Cristo Rey.
Caballeros, General Enrique Gorostieta.
Almost this Catherine you hire like you hire a whore. What'll do for us?
Who is this ranch hand who has already decided that his military strategy is better than that of a twice decorated general who fought with Huerta?
Why should we trust you?
Because I know how to lead an army. This is not about killing 14 Victoriano Ramirez. About winning the war. And a war is chess. Teniente. I've been following this war very closely. The federales, they control the trains and the towns the trains go through. The outlying towns and villages will be ours. There will be no reason to fight lined up in front of each other like ancient knights. We will fight with lightning attacks from the wings. Before they know what happened to them, the Cristeros will be gone. We will not attack from one side, but from two and sometimes three, like Ahimador and his machete. Understood? How many armed men in cavalry do we have?
General Vega.
I know who you are.
I have 4,000 men and 100 cavalry.
Good.
General Pedroza, I have 2,000. At your service, Commandant.
I have 700 armed rancheros on horseback. And I will command my own men.
And you will take orders from me?
Like hell I will.
Then why are you here?
I don't know.
Well, I do. You wanted to meet me. You knew that we needed a central command, and you wanted to see what kind of man I was. So I will tell you. And I will tell you all, I am a veteran of two wars. And I was promoted to general when I was very young. For a specific reason. Because I have a gift. Yes, I have a gift. For military strategy.
And he's humble, too.
I am now the commander of this army. If you don't show respect, you can go. Now. Go. Go to the hills and continue to fight. Raid villages until you are shot or hanged. Go. So you stay. Good. And in Vega, the entire world has heard about the priest who burned people alive. You gave Caius exactly what he needed. A way to demonize us. So now public support for our cause has been severely compromised.
Those are more of Gaius' lies.
Lies.
They have raped and killed women in front of their children. Marched them for days and days. Left them to die in corrals like diseased cattle. They have taken priests.
So you're here for revenge? Is that it, Padre? Is that why you're here? Because if you are, you can go home and pray to God that he may forgive you. Because we are now an army. We are an army fighting for God and for the church and for absolute freedom. We must work together, me and you. We might die together. But we will fight with honor and dignity and with cunning. And by the grace of God, we will be victorious. Viva Cristo Rey.
Devils burning in hell will enjoy your art.
Stop! Please, sir, stop!
Stop what?
Mayor Picasso is my padrino.
Mayor Picasso knows we are here.
Please, sir, I'm begging you.
Get out of here.
Get out of here!
To kill him.
I know, Jose. I know all about him. He's a well-known cristero. He killed a federal sergeant. And I've been waiting for him to come back to that subversive father of his.
But his father never did anything.
Don't think I don't know where you were last night. I saved your life this time, Jose. But I'm warning you. These are dark times. I won't be able to do it again. Now get up.
We're going to join the Cristeros. Cristeros?
How? They'll say we're too young.
They won't take us. Not if we tell them they will kill us here. Come on, Lalo. You and me. Together.
Find it, son.
Yeah.
Someone smuggled it on the ocean.
Check the station.
What's going on?
They've raided and closed everyone at the League offices. Many have been arrested, and God knows how many have been tortured or killed by now. We need your help.
I can't help you. The more and more I think Anacleto was right. You know, this violence has gotten us nowhere.
I understand. But I need you to take this to Urostieta.
No, Miguel.
Adriana, this is critical. Contact information for all our principal members. Without this, there will be no central command.
You would go without saying goodbye?
I can't stay here, Mother. Not while my friends and brothers are joining the Cristeros. I need to fight.
Nuestra Señora de Guadalupe. Te bendiga, mi amor. May she watch over and protect you.
Tell Papa I love him.
You will need a horse.
Are you ready?
Revenge.
Revenge for what I did?
Yes! Revenge for what you did!
Teniente, these treasures must be buried. They will become an army of grave diggers.
Thank you.
thing suits me.
Well, anything that covers that face of yours.
Oh, it must be Señora Hernández needing her medicine.
We're eating.
People count on us, Jorge. Just a minute.
Good evening. I need some medicine for my son. Can you please help me?
Of course, dear boy. Give me 1 second and I'll get the keys.
Thank you.
The police are here.
Let's go. Quickly. I'll handle the door. To the passageway.
No, Anacleto, no.
Hey. I'll be right behind you.
No, Anacleto.
Go. Hurry.
Open the door.
Anacleto González Flores? Or is it Don Jose?
I am Anacleto.
Exactly what peaceful world you're doing. We hope your friends learn from your mistakes.
May God bless and forgive you, sir. I do. Wonder about God?
Yes. I'm scared.
Me too. But Jesus is watching over us, Lalo.
Since when did you become a priest?
I'm no priest. But I believe it. I know it.
Good night, Jose.
Good night.
¿Quién vive?
Viva Cristo Rey.
Get down.
General, sir.
He's too busy to talk to you. Turn around and go home.
We won't leave until we talk to the general.
Go home now.
Aliente, who wants to talk to me? These boys, sir.
Go now.
Go, let's go. Rápido. Why are you here?
I want to be Cristeros, mi general.
And why do you want to be Cristeros?
The padre of the Church of Sahuayo was killed in front of me. He was teaching me to be an altar boy.
Marta, get this young man something to eat. Go.
Gracias, mi general.
Get up. War is no place for bums.
Not be right in the eyes of God to make you soldiers.
We can fight.
Yes, I know you can fight. But it'd be better for you to serve the cause by helping out around the camp. What I need is for you to show me that you're good workers and that you're disciplined.
First.
Wouldn't he already know?
He should confess.
The body of our Lord Jesus Christ preserve your soul to everlasting life.
Good to have you here.
Thank you.
You like Mexican food?
Well, I don't get much of it in New Jersey, but this is just delicious.
It's called mole poblano. It's made with chocolate. Chocolate. One of Mexico's pre-Columbian gifts to the world.
Oh, this is magnificent.
Thank you. What are your impressions of Mexico?
Well, I've traveled in Mexico numerous times, and, you know, I'm always charmed. And it's interesting. Invariably, I discover something that connects our two countries, chocolate and petroleum, being two of them.
American oil companies have been granted a 50-year concession that I consider very generous. Please sit.
Well, I understand there are some in Washington who don't see it that way. We've been following your war with the Catholic Church.
I would hardly call it a war.
Terrible what happened on the train.
They were led by a priest. What does that tell you about their so-called moral superiority? 51 people burned alive.
Barbaric. But surely that doesn't represent the entire Catholic population. In my experience, it's small groups of extremists that start wars.
In my experience as a revolutionary, a small group of determined men can bring down a government. And that is why every Catholic aggression must be responded to immediately, forcefully, and without hesitation. And if we continue talking politics, we're going to ruin our digestions. Ambassador, salud.
Salud.
Bienvenido a México.
Soriano.
Huh?
Don't go through the canyon, it's like a buggy. It's a trap.
How do you know that? My scout was there yesterday.
Let's just say it's a gut feeling. An ambush is what I would do if I was them.
Let me ask you something, General. I'm just curious. If we die, if you lose this war...
We're not gonna lose this war.
If you lose this war, do you still get paid all the money? Or do you get, like, half? I'm just curious.
You want something from me, Flacco? If we die, we all die. But my family will be taken care of.
That's very good for your family. We'll go through the canyon.
Of course you will. Go with God, then.
Why did you let him disrespect you that way?
Viva Cristo Rey.
Que viva.
José.
Mi general.
Chamaco's very happy to see you. He's very tired.
I heard you saved Victoriano, even though he said those things.
A man like Victoriano, respect is won. Look at him. Come here. Look how beautiful he is. He's a Frisian. His name means little child. He's a legendary warhorse from Northern Europe. In the Middle Ages, he would carry armored knights and kings into battle. His owner gave him to us specifically for our cause. He's the only one of its kind in all of Mexico. Go. Say hello.
What's it like to ride?
You tell me. You'll need to be exercised tomorrow morning. But you have to be gentle on the reins. He has a very sensitive mouth. And he's very fast. He loves to run. So you have to hold on tight. Hey, chamaco. Hey, chamaco. What's it like to ride him? It's like being close to heaven. Jose. I've never had a son, but if I did, I would want him to be just like you. Que viva Cristo Rey.
Viva!
Bueno, esto toma mi. Esta es una de las poblaciones de donde ellos encuentran mayor fortificación.
Pero ¿y cuánta gente tenemos en esta área?
Aquí en esta área tenemos unas 2,000 tropas.
Señor presidente. Mi general Ortiz and almost 500 men are dead.
Ortiz? That's impossible. Who told you that?
A counter ambush, sir. Cristeros hired Enrique Gorostieta as commander of all the Cristero forces.
General Gorostieta is behind this?
He fought with Huerta, sir.
I know that. What I don't know is how could someone like Ortiz be so incompetent? Gorostieta. His treason will not be forgotten nor forgiven. Do you understand? Go to Los Altos immediately. Bring all the men you can.
Yes, Mr. President.
Go. Go! Gorostieta is back in politics.
Yes, sir.
But I know him. His heart is not in this. Find out what he really wants.
What he does.
Porfirio Diaz used to say, a dog with a bone in his mouth doesn't bark and doesn't bite. In politics, everything has a price. Go find his.
How was the ride?
Like flying, sir.
Come here. Tomorrow morning, I'm going to lead the men into battle. You want to carry the flag?
It would be an honor, sir.
We leave at first light.
Today we are going to send a message. We are going to send a message to Caius and to the rest of the world.
that freedom is not just for writers and for politicians and for fancy documents. Freedom. Freedom is our home, our wives, our children, our faith. Freedom is our lives. And we will defend it or die trying. It is not only our duty to defend it, but it is our right. You must remember that men will fire bullets, but God decides where they land. Que viva Cristo Rey! Viva Cristo Rey! Viva Cristo Rey!
Dearest Talita, today was a magnificent day. And not simply because we routed the Federales in our greatest victory yet. There is a change in the spirit of my men. A transformation I can see in their eyes. They finally believe we can win this war. I know the Federales can sense this too. The scent of fear now blows from their camps. We must strike them harder now. Push them back. So the people will be emboldened to support us in the cities. Then Caius and his army will have nowhere to hide. My strategy cannot fail us. And I will be home before long. Keep me close in your heart, my love. And I will see you again tonight. In my dreams.
This war has Americans and other foreigners reluctant to do business or even visit. And I wonder if you can see your way to some kind of compromise.
No. But if your country and my country would strengthen their ties, this could end very quickly.
That's not what I had in mind. Actual military support is, of course, is out of the question, but I think a provision could be made for the sale of American machine guns and aircraft.
When can I get the planes?
Well, Mr. President, first we need the gesture of goodwill. I think a different position on American petroleum interests would go a long way.
I will bring your generous offer to Congress.
Get on the horse.
You'll be faster alone, General.
What are you doing? Get on the horse.
Sorry, General.
Get on the horse! Up there! They're gonna kill you! Get on the horse!
I'll be fine, General.
Leave the horse! I'll come back for you!
José!
His horse. He took a boy's horse.
He refused to get on. It was either him or me. For him myself, he wasn't among the dead. I think he either escaped to the forest or he was captured.
Send two men, search for him.
I already sent men to the forest. He'll be all right. He's braver than most men.
Leave me alone. Get my horse ready. Victoriano. That's my boy. We let him down. He inspires me, and we let him down.
This is, I found that where I left him. That was his.
Scout tells us that General Rodriguez is heading towards Tepatitlan to set up headquarters. This will be one of the most important battles of our struggle. I'm entrusting it to you. With Pedrosa and Victoriano under your command.
I'm ready, Commander.
You, Pedroso, and Victoriano will be in Tepatitlan in 2 days.
We can pull some more troops in.
If you get there first, it will not be necessary. You go into the city, you look for vantage points, buildings, rooftops, behind walls, sheltered places. There will be not one Cristero in sight.
see the gun.
We have to attack now.
Victoriano.
Ah, Lalo. Lalo, are you a strong rider?
Yes, sir.
I want you to ride like the wind to Sawaya.
Find out if Jose is there. You report back to me as soon as possible.
Yes, sir. You're only alive because the Capitan knows your padrino.
Are they going to kill us? I'm scared to do this.
This is what happens when you don't tell me what I need to know.
Oh.
I'm gonna take you home, Jose. I'm gonna take you home.
Just say the words. Death.
to Cristo Rey. Long live the federal government.
No, padrino.
Yo
no quiero.
Just words.
I can't, padrino.
Just for your mother.
Viva Cristo Rey.
Your luck has run out.
Bishop Diaz?
Yes.
Bishop Ruiz?
Yes.
Dwight Morrow. What a pleasure.
Yes. Pleasure is ours, Mr. Ambassador.
Would you care for some tea?
Please, join us.
Oh, superb, superb. The prospects of the trip have improved already. Mr. Ambassador, who actually invited us? It's important to everyone. I've been working with President Calles to try and find a solution to this madness. We are ready to listen and to bring the message to Rome. Well, I know Rome and the top prelates have not publicly claimed support for the Cristeros, but neither have they disowned them. And in this situation, their silence is deafening. This whole thing has been... it's been an unnecessary tragedy, and Caius himself sees that now, and he's ready to find a compromise with the church. And what is critical is that we reach an agreement soon so that the killings stop and services can begin again in peace, and with peace comes stability and prosperity.
Peace and stability, Mr. Ambassador.
Gentlemen, you excuse me for a moment.
Of course.
General sent me to see if you were here. You have to go. I want to go see you.
Hold on.
I'm in God's hands, Lalo. Go. Before they see you.
Complete pardon for the entire Cristero army? What should we do with the leadership? Give him a parade with confetti all the way up to Chapultepec Castle?
Well, the pardon must be universal, specifically including the leadership, or there won't be an accord. How many men did you lose with General Rodriguez in Tepatitlan? 5,000? 6,000? is how many more are you prepared to lose?
And Rome, will it accept the other terms?
I believe I can arrange a meeting with the bishops to confirm their support.
Before I give you my answer, there's something I need to do first.
What's that?
Go see an old friend. Frankly, I thought you would not come.
You came to me. This is a Cristero country.
This is Mexico, Enrique. Please join me. How's the family? Your wife, Tulita?
Very excited. Church bells will be ringing really very soon.
Salud.
You have visto rey?
Your war is coming to an end very soon.
You here to concede?
Not quite, no.
It's not my war. Is your war. You declared war on freedom.
I know you for a long time, and I know you're not a fool. So you must know this war is not about freedom. And it's not about religion. It's about who is going to decide the fate of Mexico and its people.
Well, the people of Mexico have spoken.
They did speak. When they elected me president, not you. I run things in this country.
Not for long.
An agreement is being discussed. Mexico and Rome are going to make peace.
An agreement.
No one wants this war anymore, Enrique.
Mexico is bleeding on its home fields. Mexico is hanging from telegraph poles from Monterrey to Veracruz. Of course, you need an agreement. But freedom has no compromise. By definition, it is absolute, and that's why we will be victorious. Keep your agreement.
Please spare me your rhetorical idealism and tell me. What do you really want?
Absolute freedom. Is that in the agreement?
The agreement is all but sealed.
This is yours. Your agreement. It's not ours.
You're holding your fate in your hands.
The fate of Mexico, the destiny of Mexico, it's in God's hands, not yours or mine. Que viva Cristo Rey.
American Ambassador Morrow has made a preliminary agreement between the government of Mexico and Rome.
An agreement? What kind of an agreement?
The church has been asked to forego half of its demands. In return, the government will loosen some restrictions on the clergy.
What does that mean exactly?
The extreme laws will be rescinded. Others will be officially unenforced.
And then what?
With Rome's blessing, the church bells could be ringing again within a month.
My brother died for this. For what?
Mi general, what should we do?
We will defeat this government. We will overthrow Caius, and we will establish a democratic government that respects the rights of the people, especially the basic right to worship God in peace. And with God on our side, we will prevail.
I wish I had your faith. Jose's faith. I don't know where to find it.
If your heart's open, it might find you.
Seconds, you're gonna beg me to let you spit on Cristo Rey.
Jesús, date fuerzas! Jesús, date fuerzas!
Do you have anything to tell me?
Viva Cristo Rey!
What about going to Colotlán to get platinum?
No, better to Aguas Calientes, this is safe.
General! Pick up Jose. You're going to kill him.
He's a wild.
Yes, sir.
Teniente, you plus 10 men come with me, the rest return to camp.
Yes, caballos. Yes, jinetes con el general. El resto se regresa al campamento. ¡Ya!
Say the word. You can go home.
love you. Viva Cristo Rey.
Why couldn't I save him? You tried. What kind of God would allow that to happen?
God allows us the freedom to choose. Some choose to be evil. But God can take even the most horrific events and use them for good. The cross. Maybe Jose wasn't supposed to be saved.
How could you even say that? He was just a little boy. He had a whole life in front of him.
Even as a boy, he was a martyr. We never know what God has in mind.
What God has in mind? What does he have in mind? That Rome should turn his back on us? And all the people that have given their lives for him? That's what he has in mind? Who are you going to obey? Rome or me?
I am a priest first, mi comandante.
You can still be a priest after everything you've done.
I will always be a priest. And I will pray every day for our merciful God.
What about me?
you pray for what I've done. Better pray hard. This young man died for us!
Look, Esther.
Confess.
Now?
Now.
We need to make a run for the horses. Get to a safe position. Let's go around the back.
Are you a priest first, or aren't you? Didn't you say not to worry about those who can kill the body, but those who can kill the soul?
Something like that. So, you were listening. Ego t'absolvo peccatis tuis. In nomine Patri, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti.
Yourself?
No.
But I will try.
Padre Vega's a good man. He served you well as he could. And that's all anyone can ask of us. So forgive him. And have mercy on us both.
Amen.
What they want is me. Get the men back to El Lucero. Get Padre Vega to a doctor. And a real priest.
Mi general.
Who is I say? Padre.
Que viva. Padre! Padre! Que viva Cristo Rey!
Que viva.
Que viva!
Thank you.
Thank you.